You see this mobile?
10 years back,
if somebody would have said, right, that there will be something like this, that we would have believed? Just 10 years back, we would have believed. Answer, right?
No.
Whereas you are looking like, you know, go-go, you know. And Buddha, 3x, 5y. There's something like that, no? And then it starts.
So let us not behave like that.
You see this? What is this?
Green skin.
So there are two things which has developed very robustly. Measurement and correction. On one side measurement and one side correction, and that with the communication. So today's class is on continuous glucose monitoring system. Now how many times you can do blood sugar per day maximum? How many times you will prefer to do? Preferably zero. But if compared, 5-6 days. At the most, somebody can do 7 tests per day, right? And from that 7 tests, we have to adjust diet, exercise, lifestyle, insulin dose, glycohemoglobin and complications, right? And we found out that it is not impossible, but it is very difficult. So the technology came to our rescue. So there is a small needle. IV chalu karte, you know IV?
Mm-hmm.
You know IV solution is there?
Yes.
So the small needle which nylon, this much goes inside, and to this it is connected, and it remains in the body for good 4 to 6 days. Every 5 minutes, one blood sugar is done. How frequently? Every 5 minutes, one blood sugar is done. And so that means how many blood sugars per day?
Per hour.
Calculate.
288
blood sugars, right, per day. And suppose it lasts for 4 days. So how many sugars roughly? 1000?
1152.
Right? Against 28 blood sugar. So we'll have more data, more happening automatically, more accurate, right? And there are two ways, right? You connect it and you get the data after 4 days. Now there is a device which you connect with it and you get data right now. Every 5 minutes there is an alarm and it tells you that this is a reading. So it is called looking back and it is called real time. This is advanced. It's called continuous, for latecomers, continuous glucose monitoring system in real life, real time. You can connect this and get the answer at the end of 4 days or 6 days, or you connect it with the device and you get the answer every time, every 5 minutes. So now suppose you are doing exercise, right? You want to find out. And before exercise, how much? You see that? You just see that, right? If it is a low, you will take particular carb and wait for a time. Now after that carb, how much rises? You can see that. Now you are halfway through the exercise. You can see that. At the end of the exercise, you will see that. Which is not possible by doing finger stick, or by looking at the same thing at the end of 4 days. Correction occurs in real time. And that is what exactly happens in the body. Body measures blood sugar round the clock. Body doesn't know that how much sugar is going to come inside. As the sugar comes in, body starts producing insulin and croids. And the correction occurs in real time. So now the technology is merging with a continuous glucose monitoring system which measures and there is a device in which there is a insulin is loaded, and as per your order it can give insulin in a small quantity round the clock for 24 hours. So when you combine both continuous monitoring and continuous provision of insulin, check and provide, and that is a breakthrough in technology, and that is what we are going to discuss today. Okay, now we have Rakesh with us today. He represents Medtronic, and we have relieved him of the theoretical part. We have to evaluate the patient, educate the patient, and start the pump therapy. So we'll presume that we have evaluated patient, we have educated the patient, and now patient is ready to start. So what are the instructions, right, that he will give, right, that he is going to tell us? He has, today is Sunday, right, it is holiday for him also, and he has to attend some function, right, but in spite of that he came here early in the morning, right, just to help you out. So we just welcome him.
Thank you, thank you.
Start with today's lesson. So Rakesh,
Thank you, Dr. Dalla. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the India Medtronic South Asia Training Center. This is our South Asia Training Center for therapy and the training purpose. I represent the Medtronic. Generally we demonstrate the pump and CGMS to the SCPs, that is the doctor and the patient, and of course the future, you know, diabetic educators like you. I'll directly move on to the what exactly we do when we go to the patient house, and how we generally start with our demonstration, and what we generally instruct whatever the doctor or the dietitian has explained to us to that particular patient. Now we are into the two portfolio. One is the insulin pump. Can everybody see it? You must have heard from the Dr. Dalal or Cheryl most of the time that insulin pump, because they people are expert into this insulin pump. And the second one, the Dr. Dalal has already taught you, is CGMS, continuous glucose monitoring system. So first I'll touch on the insulin pump. When we go to the patient house, generally, you know, we generally see the three parameter over there. Whether the patient is insulin dependent, of course it is insulin dependent, that is why doctor recommended insulin pump to him. He is on multiple daily injection. So doctor recommend two things to that patient. First is basal, BASAL, and second one is bolus. When you people must have aware that basal and bolus, when it comes to the long acting insulin and the short acting insulin, basal you generally called it to the glargine insulin, and the bolus for the norepinephrine short acting insulin. So we refer to the doctor prescription. Doctor already advises the basal, particular basal rate, and progressively we set that basal rate into the pump. Now what is the significance of that basal rate with respect to pump is, insulin pump can program 48 basal rate. Now what that means to you? For example, Dr. Dalal has recommended one patient for pump, and that patient was on glargine insulin. Let's consider 20 unit glargine insulin, and he has recommended him to put on pump for 15 unit as a basal, and that basal has to be divided into the four slot. Now I'll give you one example. The four slot could be 12 a.m. midnight to 4 a.m. in the morning, then 4 a.m. in the morning to the 8 a.m. again in the morning, from 8 a.m. in the morning to the 2 p.m. in the afternoon, and 2 p.m. to the again midnight. So this four slot has been designed. If if something got bouncer, you can ask me in between, So this four slot has been designed, so we can program that four basal rate into the pump, and pump will deliver into that basal automatically into the patient body. That is the beauty of the pump. So suppose the patient is facing he is getting the down phenomenon in the morning. So Dr. Dalal has told me to increase his basal from 4 o'clock in the morning to the 8 o'clock in the morning. So I can increase that basal accordingly, and that is one of the good significance or the usage of the pump, you can say, which can be differentiated from the your current multiple daily insulin option. Now, likewise, this four, we can set the 48 basal profile into the pump every half an hour, like 12 to 12:30, 12:30 to 1 o'clock, 1 o'clock to, you know, 1:30. Likewise, we can have the 48 basal profile into the pumps, and that is a more, you know, gives the more lifestyle changes to the, or, you know, lifestyle flexibility to the patient. For example, patient is get, and this basal is generally for, you know, designed to take care of the, as we all know, that pre-meals values, fasting, 3 a.m. critical reading, pre-lunch and pre-dinner. So if your basal is correct, then the your all pre-meals going to be correct. So hope you people are, you know, understanding what I am trying to say. The basal, what is the significance of basal with respect to pump? Pump will deliver basal automatically. We just have to program it. It will deliver automatically into the patient body. In fact, you, most of people must have used the pump in your, you know, practices at your respective clinic. So you must have, you know, gone through this basal setting and all that. I'll just pass out on this pump. You can just have the look on the pump, and the you can see the how generally it looks and what are the peripheries and all about. Okay, later on after this small demonstration. Now, when it comes to the bolus, we already know that bolus is, it's your, you know, field of choice, because you people are the more responsible, the dietitian are more responsible for the bolus setting. In pump, we have the one of the great, you know, wizard in, you know, the Harry Potter movie called it as a wizard, like magic. So we have a function called as a bolus wizard. You people calculate the insulin carb ratio, insulin sensitivity factor for that respective patient, and we feed that insulin carb ratio and insulin sensitivity factor into the pump, and pump advises the patient how much insulin has to be taken for that particular meal. And trust me, Cheryl is the master in that bolus wizard option. So bolus wizard, suppose patient is put on pump, then the doctor advises use him, you know, bolus wizard, and by looking at his daily calorie content and the insulin carb and all this factor, we generally calculate his that meal carb, and accordingly pump advises him the how much insulin bolus has to be taken. This bolus has to be taken manually from the pump. He has to press the button. I am not sure whether it will be visible for you people, but I'll just demonstrate here. See, there are the 5 button. You can see the screen. So this pump has been done, bolus, basal, infusion set, or a cannula, or a patch. This is a Teflon particle which goes into the subcutaneous to the patient body, through which insulin been delivered through the pump. So fine, I'll just move through the small hands-on practice to the of the insulin pump. So as I already mentioned you here, insulin pump, which has a main menu, bolus, suspend, sensor, basal, reservoir, setup, utilities. We will touch, you know, very basic things about pump. Not necessary to, you should remember the all this stuff, because once doctor and you people recommend pump to us, it is our duty to tell the other, you know, factor like sensor, reservoir and the utilities and all that. But you people, the dietitian, are responsible for the bolus setting. You people tell us, okay, his ICR and ISF is like that, so meant, you know, adjust accordingly and ask him to take the bolus as per the requirement. So bolus is like a, we have to go into the bolus setup, press the act, and it will. So bolus, as I already mentioned you people are the most has to be concerned about bolus, that how much bolus is taken. And yes, bolus is responsible for his postprandial. If your bolus and calculation has been wrong, then the postprandial going to be high. So we are, I mean, why I am forcing again and again on bolus, because generally patient comes to us, I mean, ye khaya tha, wo khaya tha, and then my bolus goes, I mean, my readings goes high. So we generally, you know, ask the dietitian or doctor, sir, this is happening, so what should to do? Now we have the, you know, two pumps actually available in the market. One is the Paradigm 754. Actually, we have the, and another is the 722. Their Paradigm is 722 model. Okay, as per as the holding capacity, as I told you, there are the 3 peripheries that has to be used into the pump. One is the cannula, that is called as infusion set. Second one is the insulin reservoir or insulin holding container, and third one is the insulin delivery tube. So Cheryl was telling you the, you know, it was the capacity of the insulin, how much a pump is holding the insulin unit. We have the pediatric version, that is 180 unit holding. So this is the reservoir, this is the insulin delivery tube, and this is the patch, or you can say the infusion set. So I'll show you the different pump overview part. You can see the 5 buttons, one blank screen over here. This B button is called as a express bolus. Patient wanted to take a bolus, so, and he wanted to take a bolus instantly, so he can go to this option called as B, and he has to press the B, and it will prompt you how much bolus has to be set, and you have to set that bolus and give the command by pressing ACT. ACT is a command button, or you can say the in our mobile the OK key. Also act as a main menu screen, main menu button, like in our iPhone or like that in Android phone. We have to press the menu button and it will take you through the main menu's options. Same as ACT, resembles that. Escape button is like a back button or status button. If you want to come out from any menu, escape button has to be pressed, or else if you want to see the what exactly patient is doing with the pump, the escape button can be used as a status screen. Up and down button is like a scroll up and scroll down button. Now generally pump works on the AAA battery. Okay, as we have inserted the AAA battery, the screen will flash. Three main component will be shown on pump. One is the insulin reservoir, the time, which is a very critical factor, that patient has to set the correct time, because as I already mentioned you, basal will run depending on what you have set during that time. If your time is mismatched, the basal will be mismatched to the patient body.
Traveling abroad, suppose they are going to the US or any other country, they have to change the time on the pump. How you change the time on your watch? Similarly, they have to change it on the pump, otherwise the pump will work according to Indian time, the sugars will go all haywire. And then when do they change? When they reach the place is when they change the time.
And the third option is the battery indicator, that like in our mobile, that how much battery is remain with the pump. Yeah, this is small specification that we are from USA, so it is manufactured in USA and all that. Home screen, yeah, we threw it.
The reservoir button, if you look at the reservoir icon, it will tell you how much insulin is there. So basically, it warns you before time. There is a setting where you can say that when do you want the warning. Do you want it when there is only 20 units? So usually we tell our patients is that, suppose you know that per day consumption of insulin for you is say 20 units. So you keep a warning say 2 days before when there is 40 units or whatever you want to keep, so that you get a heads up. Like that day I had a call from a patient at 3:30 in the morning. She's from Dubai, saying that she's staying in her grandmother's house and there's only 1 unit of insulin left in the reservoir. And the patient did not even keep a pen. So I had to tell the mother that you have to go to the grandmother's house, because otherwise sugars are already 300 plus. And 1 unit is not going to be sufficient. She doesn't have a pen with her. If she had a pen, then it's okay. If the pump has stopped delivering insulin, we could have given from the pen. But then in the night at 3 o'clock, the mother had to go to the house to, change the patch and change the reservoir. So that is why it's important. And that's why we always tell our patients to keep an insulin pen. So a NovoRapid pen should always be with them, because in case your pump stops working and you're in some place where there is no, for the Medtronic person to come out, you do not have your insulin reserve, at least with the pen you can take insulin. So make sure that when you're counseling patients, all your patients keep a pen with them at all times.
As I already mentioned, this ACT button also act as a main menu option. Like once you press ACT, it will take you through the other sub menus like bolus, suspend, sensor, reservoir setup and all that. Scroll up and scrolling bar, it will take you to the next sub menus like utilities, reservoir set and all that. Yeah, the magic, as I already mentioned you, that you people will be more toward or concerned toward this particular part called as bolus wizard setup. Trust me, it is a wonderful tool to be used if Dr. Dalal or any doctor who has suggested that this is a perfect ideal candidate for insulin pump, with respect to all physically, mentally, educationally and financial background and everything, then this option works like anything. Like I have seen, I have installed almost 200 plus patients on pump right now. So in my experience, I have seen that those patients who use this bolus were perfectly, they have maintained their A1C, you know, in between 6 to 7 over a period of years. And this is a wonderful tool. I really use this tool with the patient and really got very good result out of it. So bolus wizard option here, we generally has to set, just press next. We have to set the different option, okay? Like ICR, ISF and the insulin, active insulin time.
The pump, we use the insulin which is a rapid acting insulin. We do not, we used to use regular insulin like Actropid or Hume insulin R, but today we're using the rapid acting insulin because it has a shorter duration of action. But very important to remember is, suppose you inject the insulin, you know that it is in the body for around 4 to 6 hours. So if I take insulin again after 2 hours, because most of our patients have a habit of eating a mid-meal snack. Suppose you've had your breakfast and again at 10 o'clock you're eating something, then if the patient takes insulin, then it will have a compounded effect because the action of my previous insulin is still there. And I'm taking insulin, then that will have a compounded effect and the patient's sugars will go low. So in the pump, there is a feature called active insulin time. That means if I'm taking my next shot of insulin, if I feed in that I'm taking say 30 grams of carbs, my sugar right now is at 200. The pump itself will tell me, okay, you need to take so much of insulin, but there is still 1.5 units of insulin active. So you need to take say 5 units of insulin, 1.5 is active. So actually you need to take only 3.5 units of insulin. So that is the active insulin time. And it's very important, like, you know, I always tell my patients, because I've come across a lot of patients who do not use the bolus wizard. I tell them, if you do not want to use it, there's no point of going on the pump. The pump is only, you know, you're paying lakhs of rupees. Otherwise, you can just do with your syringe and, you know, vial, or you can do with your insulin pen. But when you're going on the pump, it's like having, you know, upgrading to an Android or an iPhone where you have so many features. So might as well explore those features and take maximum benefit. Others, we've got patients who are 6 years on the pump and do not even use the bolus wizard option. Then it makes no sense. So active insulin time, and again, there are different times. So like for the child, the active insulin time will be different. For an adult, it will be different. For a pregnant woman, it will be different, which the doctors set. Or the doctors tell the Medtronic, or the Medtronic person himself will set it. So that is a very important thing. And when they use the bolus wizard will keep the active insulin in mind and then suggest how much insulin you have to take. Is that clear?
Yeah.
So usually active insulin time is in terms of hours. So you can have it between 4 to 6 hours, depending on what insulin you're using.
Basal setup, as I already mentioned you, that we have to, doctor will suggest to this much basal has to be set into the pump, and accordingly you can set the basal by going into the basal setup.
As he said, you can set 48 basals on your pump. So every half an hour there can be a separate basal. Usually in practice, we do not have more than 4 to 6
basals. Right.
Okay, so it again depends on the patient's activity. The best part about the pump is you can have a different setting every day. So there are different patterns you can follow, because typically you have children who use the pump. So on a weekday, their routine is very different to a weekend. Weekend they wake up late. So if they follow the same routine as a weekday, their sugars will start going very low. So you can set a different basal to a weekend, and that's a timing, because the moment the pump knows it's a weekend, it will automatically switch to pattern.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have pattern A, pattern B, so you can switch on to that. Basals is basically for your pre-meal blood sugar. So if the pre-meal blood sugars are not under control, that means the basals are not set right. So basal setting will reflect on your pre-meal blood sugars. Bolus settings will reflect on your post-meal blood sugars. So that's how we basically analyze whether basals are not right or bolus is not right. Or is the patient in the habit of grazing too much? Like every time, you know, every 5 minutes a patient wants to eat something, then obviously we will not get good sugar control.
4 basal rate from the glargine insulin, right? We have to give one shot and it will deliver throughout the day. But here we can have the 4, 5, 6 basal rate and it will deliver with our wish. You know, how much we have to deliver it into our body, that much basal rate will be delivered into the body.
And suppose I'm going for an exercise. Okay, I'm worried my sugars may go low. So you can actually set the pump, you can set a temporary basal saying that 1 hour before exercise, during exercise and 1 hour after exercise, I can reduce my basal by 50%. That means if say 1 unit is going per hour, if I set it to 50%, only 0.5 units will go per hour. and it will automatically come back to its normal after 4 hours. So you can do that. Suppose you're going out for a buffet dinner and you know you're going to be eating for the next 4 hours, you can actually increase your basal by 50% or 25%. Suppose a person is unwell, or suppose there is any event that is happening, you can actually increase and decrease, and it can be only temporary because it's only for that particular time and that particular day. You can go back to your normal basal from the next day. So that's a very good feature that is there. Variations in the basal dose by 0.025. We always, like, even if you look at the landmark studies that we have seen, that, you know, the incremental increase should be done very, very slowly. So we only increase by 0.025 units per hour. And suppose it's, say, 0.6 units per hour it's going. So when you do it by 0.025, it will be 0.625 units per hour. If you do very high incremental changes, then there are very high chances that the patient may go into hypoglycemia. So always the change should be very, very small.
See, this is standard basal that, you know, doctor asked me to sit for the 24 hours, and I have selected this 4 slot actually, from 12 a.m. to 3 a.m., 0.5 unit per hour. That means from 12 to 1, 0.5 will be delivered, 1 to 2.5 unit will be delivered, and 2 to 3.5 will be delivered. From 3 o'clock in the morning till 8 o'clock, doctor asked me to increase the basal, like 0.6 unit per hour, and from 8 o'clock, till the midnight 12 again 0.5 unit, or 4 p.m. it was 0.8 unit per hour. So we will directly move to the next.
When you go to basal review, you can see that how many basals are set. So, you know, when you ask the patient, he will tell you 3 o'clock. So 3 will be one basal. Then the next time will be, say, 6. That means 3 to 6, that is the basal, which is at 3. Then 6 o'clock again it changes. Then maybe at 12 o'clock again you want a different basal. So again it depends on the patient's routine. Suppose it's a child going to school. At school, they are very, you know, they want to be a little cautious that they don't want the child to go into hypo. So slightly lower basal. But when the child comes home, the child is eating and all that, maybe you'll have a higher basal. Suppose it's an activity day, then maybe basals will be lower. All that should be done by the doctor. I don't think we should change the basals. It should all be done by the doctor, because then it's a risk that you're taking. It's better not to, you know, interfere with the basal settings. Bolus, yes, you can. Again, bolus also, we try and, you know, make the meals very standardized so that patient is eating fixed meals at breakfast, lunch and dinner, so that he takes the same amount of bolus. Otherwise, they're actually encouraging, because when it's carb counting, patients think that, you know, I can eat jalebis and I can eat, every day I can eat something, you know, because they're only counting carbs. They'll eat a motichur laddu, they'll eat a samosa and all that, and they keep taking more insulin. So we shouldn't encourage that. How we plan our diets, we should make sure that whatever options we plan. So suppose you're giving, you know, we give more than 3 to 4 options, right? So all your options should have the same amount of carbs. So the exchange should be the same, so that the patient knows whether I'm eating poha or upma or dosa or idli. This is the amount of carbs, and for this carbs, I need to take so much of insulin. So that, you know, it's easier, because otherwise when we tell them to take more and less, then they play around and then their sugars go all haywire. So we have to also keep in mind that it's not only about sugar, chapter it's one. About lipids, it's about weight, it's about everything. So we shouldn't encourage them to eat anything wrong if they are doing carb counting. That's a very important thing, because patients otherwise take it for granted that they can eat anything they want if they are doing carb counting. Because what happens is, see, when we are giving insulin injections, we tell them to rotate sides. Why are we telling them to rotate sides? Otherwise there is lipoatrophy, right? And then that portion becomes very, very hard. And then whatever insulin that they're taking, you know that only 50% is going in, 50% is getting wasted. So what happens at the pump is that pump, the patch is there at the same site for the next 3 to 4 days. Now what happens with patients is, this is expensive. Okay, they have to pay for these consumables. So what they do is they do not remove the patch for 5 to 7 days. So then that portion becomes very thick, and then the insulin, you will see that towards the 4th, 5th day, the sugars are going a little haywire. And that is not because the pump is not working, it's only because they haven't changed the patch. So please encourage your patients to change the patch every 3 days, even if it amounts to cost. Because if they don't change the patch, they will actually spend more, because more insulin will be required. So might as well that you know, emphasize on the need to change the patch. And once we train them, and again the patch has to be the same, you know, like how you change your sites. Similarly, suppose they put the patch here, but the next time they'll have to put it maybe on another site. and we encourage them to keep changing sites every time they change the patch, okay? And suppose that portion, like, you know, where the patch area is looking a little thickened, then we tell them not to touch that area for the next 1 month or till that portion has subsided, because otherwise your insulin absorption will be. And even the cannula, somebody who's thinner, you'll need a slightly smaller cannula size. If it's an obese person, then obviously you'll need a slightly bigger cannula size. So that is what they have.
Yeah, we have this. This is a 23-inch tube, and for the, you know, fatty body, we have the 43-inch tubing. And as far as the cannula, the depth of the cannula, we have the 6 mm cannula and 9 mm cannula. So, you know, we will just finish it up, and practically we will do how to insert into the subcutaneous or human body. Okay.
The inner barrel. Remove the paper bagging by gently lifting up one tab at a time. While you do this, place a finger on the edge of the needle guard to ensure the infusion set does not become dislodged. With the inserter in one hand, pull down the blue button until the two white buttons click into place. Twist and loosen the needle guard, then pull it straight up to remove it. To insert the infusion set, place the quick inserter flat against your body over the prepped infusion site. With the inserter secure against your body, press the two white buttons at the same time to insert the set. Put a finger on the blue handle to hold the infusion set in place. Push down on the top of the blue button to release the infusion set from the quick inserter. Now, pull the inserter away from your body. Place your fingers on the infusion set and pull the introducer needle straight out. Smooth down the adhesive. The quick set infusion set allows you to temporarily disconnect from your pump. To disconnect your infusion set, firmly hold the adhesive to your skin. Then hold the two indentations on either side of the cannula housing and turn it counterclockwise until the blue arrow is aligned with the blue arrow on the adhesive. Pull the cannula housing up to disconnect from your site hole.
Fill in insulin, because you can take around 300, or, you know, patients ask us, you can fill in 300 units of insulin in the reservoir. Now, if I'm going to change it in 3 days, suppose my daily requirement is only 20 units, 3 days will be 60 units. If I'm going to change the reservoir, then do I need to waste that insulin? Not necessary. You do not need to fill the reservoir to 300 units. Suppose your daily requirement is, say, 20 units, so 60, plus you keep another 20% extra, because considering that you may take a little more insulin on a particular day, so you take 20% extra, so you will put 60 plus 20% in the reservoir, so that you're not wasting insulin. Is this clear? Okay, so that is what we tell patients, and that's what they do.
And the infusion set or the cannula with me? Okay, now as we have already seen into AV, how to generally, you know, fit it into the quick setter. So I'm just fitting it. This tube has to be out from this, you know, gap. Adjust it. Make sure it is adjusted. Then by holding here, pull out this sticker paper. Done. You can see, no, ma'am. I'm loading it. By loading it, this two white button automatically came out, right? These are the, you know, you can say the act button for this inserter. Once we the whole, you know, press this both buttons simultaneously, then only the infusion set will go into the subcutaneous. Now after doing this, I have to disconnect this needle cap. No, we have to rotate it anti-clockwise. Fine. Then we have to take the position. Great. Let's have the clap for Aditi. And don't worry, Aditi, we'll just insert it. After 2-3 minutes, we will take it out. So no need of any infection or nothing like that.
No metal part enters into your body.
Yeah.
See, the procedure is simple. When we start IV, right? Right? That you apply, make it tense, right? And you insert, right? And the needle part, you take it out. So the nylon cannula remains inside. same principle it is there, but here rather than IV inside the vein, it is below the skin in a subcutaneous tissue. And the length is how much?
Six millimeters.
Right? Around half centimeter.
See, I selected the place, okay? Then I'm just pressing the both buttons simultaneously. Then pressing from up.
One minute.
So now see, the needle is inside. You can just go. Needle is inside. I'm taking the needle back. This is needle. I will discard it, and then what remain inside it? Teflon cannula. After doing this, we have to just observe that whether it is inserted perfectly or like that. Like, you know, when we give the injections to the patient, sometimes the microcapillary rupture happen and you know, blood come out. So sometimes it happens with the cannula also. So no need to worry here. I have placed it rightly. So now you tell Aditi, how's your experience like when I was inserting it? Matlab kya kuch laga aapko? Nahi laga?
It's a small prick.
Prick, yeah. It is, as my colleague Satish already told you, it is virtually painless. You will not feel anything.
CGMS will tell the pump what the sugar reading is. And the best part is it will also prompt you about how it's trending. Is it trending upwards? Is the sugar trending upwards? Or is it trending downwards? So it will also give you an indication of how the sugars are going to be in the next few hours. So the patient can take corrective action. So if they know that the sugar is trending downwards, it will show you arrows downwards. So then you know that you have to do something, that the sugars otherwise will go low. So it will give you a prediction, which is great. So that's the best advantage of having the CGM and the pump together.
Yeah, now Aditi has placed the cannula on her, you know, subcute. She will feel that something has little bit attached to her body for a, you know, first day. This cannula will be on her body for 3 to 4 days, you know, generally what we recommend to the Indian patient. And progressively we change the site, you know, rotation has been happened, like we rotate our insulin injections sites. Now I am through with the insulin pump. The good thing about pump, battery and insulin reservoir, when the battery is going to get die or when battery going to get empty, 24 hour before, pump will prompt you that low battery alarm. So low battery alarm itself indicate that after 20, you have sufficient 24 hour to change the battery. Don't wait to, you know, to get over that 24 hour and change the battery. Change the battery during that 24 hours. Second, one triple battery lasts for the almost half an month. So you have sufficient time to, you know, to use the pump on one battery. Second, as far as the insulin reservoir is concerned, as we have already mentioned, insulin reservoir hold the 300 unit of insulin. When 20 unit remain with the reservoir, pump will prompt you that low reservoir warning. So you have the, you know, 20 unit with you, sufficient 20 unit with you, but still you have to change the reservoir. So this is caution you have to be taken when you are using the insulin pump, like battery.
With a 40 IU vial, it has to be loaded with a 100 IU cartridge. Okay, the ones they use in the pump, in the pens. Because if you load it with a 40 IU, your calculations are all going wrong. So whether it's a vial, it has to be a 100 IU per ml vial, or it has to be a 100 IU per ml cartridge. Very important thing.
See, this is a reservoir. We have two different types of reservoir. One is a 3 ml, that is a it can hold 300 units of insulin, and the other which is for pediatric patients, that is a 1.8 ml. So that would be like 180 units per holding capacity. So it is a simply like this, and it has a two-way guard needle. So we can see a needle on both the side. So I'll just do it like this, and there is a small piston, just like a small normal syringe we have, insulin syringe. So on the other side, I'll take the insulin vial, I'll just insert, press it little bit. It will be fixed, right? Then I'll just pull on the this piston back, and I'll take the insulin inside the reservoir. I'll just make sure there is no air bubble into the reservoir. It should not be there. If there is any reservoir, just take out the vial and just remove the whatever air bubbles are there, and just keep the 20 units extra. Like as the Rakesh said, if the patient's daily dose is 20 units, so accordingly we need to fill 60 units. But additionally, we take a 20 units extra into the reservoir. But for the priming or any odd day, if patient takes to any high meals and everything, for additional bolus. So additionally, take 20 units into the reservoir. Just take out this, just rotate this
plunger
back and just remove it. And on the same way, just remove this two-way needle. And just with that, he is in infusion state. Again, we just need to just push little bit and rotate, as the we have seen into the video. We just need to push and then rotate it. So that is with the reservoir.
You can feel the with your wish, you know.
Yes.
Generally, how we generally you know, use the cannula for 3 to 4 days, you can say you know, use the reserve for that 3 to 4 days also. Suppose patient daily requirement is 50 unit, he is on basal bolus therapy, total daily requirement is 50 unit. For 4 days, you can fill 200 unit into the reservoir. So 200 unit reservoir will last for 4 days, and it will give you alarm on how many units. Can anybody tell me? Agar maine 200 bhar liya hai to kaun se, it will give you alarm on what? Yeah, so no, 20 unit. I said 20 unit when 20 units with the,
that is with battery. One day prior, 24 hours prior, it will show, give you the alarm.
It depends on whatever you set in your
order.
So basically, you can have that setting that when do you want the alarm.
Yeah.
Do you want it when there is 20 units? Do you want it when there is 100 units? You have the flexibility to set it. So everything is, there is a default, but there is a setting option where you can go and set how you want. Suppose you set it at 50, it will tell you.
It will give prompt on 50 unit.
That's why we always tell our patients to keep an extra cartridge with them. So basically, they should have a kit with an extra cartridge and an extra insulin pen, so that anything goes wrong, they can always, and even a quick set, they have to. Because sometimes what happens is, our patients say that the insulin delivery, you know, the sugars, how much ever correction they're taking, the sugars are still 300 plus, it's not coming down. That means the delivery is not happening. Now, there is a very high probability that, you know, there is a blood clot which is there in the tube. There is a backflow of blood, and that has gone and blocked your tubing. So if the tubing is blocked, insulin delivery will not happen. So we tell the patients to check that, and if that is there, then they have to change the patch. Sometimes because of moving and all, there is a kinking in the tube. You know, especially with children, because they are so active, there could be a kinking. So then, even then, we tell them you have to change the patch. So any doubt, change the patch.
The insulin is filling into this reservoir, I'll just put it into the insulin pump. So there is some slot for the insulin reservoir. I'll just insert this reservoir and just rotate like this. Done. Then before putting onto the body this patch, we need to prime this insulin infusion set, because there is air inside and we need to fill it in with insulin. So there are some options. When we go into the ACT menu, there is a reservoir option, reservoir and setting. So I'll go into that, and there is a rewind option. So I'll rewind the pump first and then insert this reservoir, and I just need to press ACT button unless till the time when I see a drop here. I'll keep on pressing this ACT button. By the time I see this insulin from here, I'll just release this button so that the insulin is already completely filled into this tubing. And then I can put on the this patch.
So one is, you have to suspend it. Once you suspend, the insulin delivery will stop. And then as Rakesh showed you in the presentation, there is a cap which is there. So you remove this and then you put a cap, and then the person can go and swim, have a bath, whatever. So basically, when bathing and swimming, they have to remove their pump. Okay, we've had instances where patients have taken the pump to the bathroom, the pump has fallen in water, and then it's become very difficult. So basically, should not be put in water. I mean, try and avoid that.
Yeah, the latest pump that we are coming out will be the waterproof only. So, you have seen the plenty of sometimes the simple and the difficult procedure over here. But trust me, when we put patient on pump, we give rigorous training. We've been behind a patient for, you know, having, he should be expert into the pump usage and everything. So you no need to worry, like you have seen this first time, and it is like bouncer to you. So don't need to worry. when you people or a doctor recommend any patient on pump, you Medtronic team, doctor, we will be in loop at least for a 3 to 6 months to take care of that patient each and every pick and falls. So no need to worry about if you think anything is going bouncer or like that. We give the rigorous training on the when patient actual put on pump. Now I will just move through the CGMS IV last three rows. So guys, we have the three pumps right now available with us, and I'll just quickly go through the differences with these three pumps. We have the basic version, which only has a capability of delivering of basal and bolus. That version is called a 722. We named different model with different version, so it has a 722 name. The next, the middle model, we have the VO model. The VO pump is our first breakthrough of CGMS technology, collaboration of CGMS technology and insulin delivery. So there is a two patches. One is the CGMS patch, another one is the insulin pump patch, and you can see the live feeding of readings on the pump on every fifth minute. So as a Dr. Dalal told you, there is a flexibility of having the reading on 24/7. So this pump has given us advantage of seeing the live reading 24/7 on pump. So suppose I am the patient and I want to see, I'm talking whether my readings are getting up or getting down, so I could see easily on that pump. While with the CGMS, which is a blinded one, we have to take out the report that Dr. Dalal and Cheryl will take you after some time, and how it is to be done, they will take you through. But I'm just telling you, this middle pump has the flexibility of seeing the reading on the pump.
Yes. So, but for that LGS to work, you have to have the sensor.
Sensor.
You can't have an LGS work. LGS means suppose the sugar. Suppose you tell the pump that at 60 you want the pump to switch off, because 60 is dangerous, right? Any blood sugar less than 60 is dangerous. So the pump, the moment the CGM will prompt the pump that the sugar is now 60, the pump switches off its insulin delivery. So the risk of hypoglycemia is nullified. But for that, the patient has to have the CGM on. Only then will the LGS thing work. So that's like a proper...
Yeah. You won't find that... won't find any difference with the basic model and the middle model.
Another important thing is, suppose sometimes, the sensors. Now, always remember that the sensor is actually, identifying the interstitial fluid glucose. Mm-hmm. Now, sometimes we have got patients whose sugar is showing 40 on the pump, and they have absolutely no symptoms of hypoglycemia. They're feeling all right. They don't feel they're hypoglycemic. We don't tell them to act on that reading. We tell them to do a finger prick, to do a blood glucose reading on a meter. And whatever the meter tells, we tell them to believe what the meter tells. Because there have been instances where the pump has shown it's 40, the meter is saying it's 120. So then 120 is what we would go with. Because there could be a lag,
yeah.
Especially when there is a postprandial. After meals, the lag is more. So then, this is just to give you an indication of how the sugars are, but it does not say that you do not need to do blood glucose testing. You still need to do blood glucose testing. Anytime in doubt, blood glucose monitor, and we will rely on the blood glucose monitor.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. In fact, Cheryl, share that very important part, interstitial fluid. To get sensor activated, we have to have the good interstitial fluid background and good glucose quantity over there. Until and unless, if it is not there, which is not in our hand also, the sensor behaves haywire. So CA has rightly told you that we have to take care of the calibration reading of blood glucose, and also for the calibration we require the blood glucose readings. And third, now I'll just touch the third model that we are going to come up in next month. It is the another step toward the artificial pancreas, or closing loop toward the artificial pancreas. It has a predictive alarms. If you are using a sensor and suppose the pump is guessing that you are going to get low in next 1 hour, so it will stop you there itself that you are going to get low. So it will give you a predictive that after 1 hour you are going to get into severe hypoglycemia. So stop whatever activity you are doing right now, or take a corrective major action. That is the next pump we are going to launch in market. It has a color display, it has a iPhone interface. Many things we are going to have into that pump. But so that's all.
That's the cost.
As far as the cost is concerned, Yes, it is in lakhs. First model will cost you 2,20,000, basic model. Second model VO will cost you 3,30,000.
The patient has to use it. It's like you have your phone and you're just using it to pick up and disconnect calls, and I don't think you need to use that kind of phone. So
yeah.
It's only that you have to, like, and it's beautiful because the more you use it, we actually do not teach the patients at the first go everything. Because then they play around and then they end up taking so much insulin and they go into hypo and all. So basically, initially they teach them only basics, and in a month's time then they, you know, start teaching patients the different features. First they want them to get comfortable, because you know some people are even apprehensive to using the pump. They say it reminds me 24/7 that I'm a diabetic. So that's their first barrier. Second is, especially in women, they feel that, you know, it will tell everybody that they're diabetic. They do not want to tell because they don't know how to keep it. For parents, they are concerned that, you know, in the child's uniform, how do I manage to keep the pump? How, what kind of clothes do I need to wear? So there are a lot of concerns that are there. How do I sleep with it? Because they're very scared when they're sleeping. Suppose, you know, the tubing comes out, then the insulin delivery will stop. So there are a lot of apprehensions and a lot of questions. So instead of us answering them, what we do is basically get them connected to somebody who's already on the pump. I think that's the best thing, because they give them a lot of confidence, and then the patient becomes more willing to go on the pump. Because we telling them may not really, you know, work that much. So always connect them, and they basically form groups where they are in touch and they constantly keep telling each other what they are doing. And I think that's a good way of actually using social media to get more comfortable with it. And initially we tell them to have, so basically even when it comes to the meals, we tell them to have simple meals, not to have too much of outside food, because then we will not be able to fix the bolus too. So when they have good home cooked food, which is more having simple carbs, then you know they are able to identify what the bolus is. Even the doctor is able to set the basis right, because otherwise the whole basis setting will not be right. And very important is when the patient goes on the pump, the basis have to be set right, because that is like 50% of the job is done, and your bolus then can manage everything else. But basals to be set right is the most important thing in the pump.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you so much for adding that, Cheryl. And right now we are, since long we launched the pump, we follow one protocol. We generally don't ask patient directly go on pump. We generally ask them to have a trial rental program for it. We generally design one very good, beautiful program called as TBYB, try before you buy. So try for a 1 month, 2 month, 3 month. We are currently associated with the JDF. Dr. Dalal is a head of advisory committee over there, and we have been running this campaign with the JDF, and we got very good success out of it, that for the JD has to put on pump for 3 months at least on rental program, and we have to see how the 4 year replacement warranty.
And then they have upgrades. So basically in the US, if you see, it's given free of cost, as well as whenever they come up with an upgrade, like Rakesh told you, they're coming up with a new model.
Yeah.
The patient will be informed, the old pump will be taken, the new one will be given free of cost. But in India, it's not the case. Here, if you have to upgrade, you have to pay. Without the bullets, the pump is of no use. It's like a gun without bullets. So again, we have, you know, sometimes we have a lot of these high profile patients who decide to donate pumps, who decide to do some charity work and, you know, gift pumps to their poor patients. We've had this. But we always tell them, don't stop there. If you are willing to give the consumables and the cost that is occurring every month, then you give the pump. Otherwise, it's no point. Because if you're going to give somebody who's earning like 10,000 rupees a month, you're gifting a pump, the person will never use the pump. It will just be lying in the cupboard, because the consumables, like one quick set, is 380 rupees. That has to be changed every 3 days. So you think in a month they'll need 10 quick sets. So 10 quick sets is 3,800 rupees. Then you will have the insulin cost, right? So all this is at least a minimum of 6,000 rupees a month.
Yeah, exactly.
More than that. Six, and plus with that, you have to do your blood glucose testing. So you assume 6,000 to 7,000 is a fixed cost per month. If the person is earning 10,000 rupees, will he be able to afford that? So there's no point gifting the pump to such a patient unless you're ready to even bear the cost of the monthly consumable. So very important when you have such patients, because we've had these cases wherein, you know, our patients have decided to give the pump but not volunteered to give the, you know, cost, which happens monthly.
Yeah.
So that is something that you have to tell patients, and patients should be told. And also they think that once they go on the pump, they do not need to do blood glucose testing. they think pump pe gaye matlab mera abhi sugar testing band. No, in fact sometimes it is more, because if you want them to use the pump effectively, it is very important that they know what their pre-meals are and take insulin according to the carb count and their blood sugar reading. So at least 3 blood glucose tests a day is something that we would advise patients on the pump, for them to use the pump effectively. So these are things which you as an educator, you know, using the pump, all that, the Medtronic people do it very well. Servicing, all that is done. But you have to tell the patients the facts and how to explore the best out of the pump. That is our job as an educator. Basal setting will be done by the doctor. That is not something that we should interfere with. But bolus, is the patient's bolus right? For that, you will have to look at what kind of meals is the patient eating. Again, in the pump, you have various features, like you have a normal bolus, you have a square bolus. Now see, when I'm taking insulin with just regular insulin with the pen. Now what happens is, I have to take it at one time and the insulin will work. But I have the flexibility with the pump that if I'm eating a high carb meal or simple carb meal, I can take a normal bolus, which will all go at one shot. But suppose I'm eating a protein rich meal, you know, my meal is mostly chicken tikka, chicken tandoori, or I'm eating for a period of 3 hours, or I'm having desserts, Indian desserts which are high protein, high fat. Just the normal bolus will not help. I will need to take a square bolus, now what happens in square bolus is, suppose I have to take 10 units over a period of 4 hours, every hour 2.5 units of insulin will go for the next 4 hours. So my sugars after 4 hours is going to be good. So this goes and just adds on to my basal dose. So basal is going, I square the bolus, that adds up to my basal. So my sugars after 4 hours is also going to be good. Because otherwise we have patients when they're eating outside, especially in the night when they have their Mughlai meals, which is very high fat. Sugars in the morning are crazy. It's 400, 300 plus. So for that, we tell them to use a dual weight bolus. Dual is, some part of it goes just now. Like for a pizza, it works very well. Because pizza is a good combination of a simple carb, which is your bread, and then lots of cheese, which becomes fat. So if in a pizza, you just take normal bolus, your sugars are not going to be good. But if you do a dual bolus, dual is, you take some amount as normal, say 20% goes as normal. So out of 10 units, 2 units goes as normal. The remaining 8 units, you spread it over 4 hours. So every hour, 2 units goes. So after 4 hours, also your sugar will be good. So that is the advantage of the pump. So, you know, you have to use these features. Otherwise, investing 5.5 lakhs, 3.5 lakhs makes no sense if you are not going to use these features. So your job is to tell the patient, please start using these features. Because Rakesh would have told the patient, but he's not paid attention. He's just taking insulin because it's more easy. They've not yet explored the pump its full potential.
Especially if the patient is open to this kind of a...
He has to be open.
Yeah.
I think they are open. It's only that they need to be told again that, you know, this is
educated properly.
And they have to be told that with the pump, you know, you cannot just look at carbs. You have to look at fat. You have to look at protein. You cannot be eating jalebis and rasgullas and this and that every day. Absolutely no, do not encourage that at all. Because otherwise your patient is just going to take advantage of not setting the right foundation. And your patient is going to go haywire with his lipids and with everything else. Okay, so it is good. It gives you a lot of flexibility. Like, it's nice. You know, we tell them, if you're eating a larger meal, make sure you take more insulin. Another good thing is, you know, especially with our children, is that they want to eat something substantial at 4 and 5 in the evening. Now, what happens is, when they eat a substantial snack at 4 and 5, which is more high carb, their sugars pre-dinner is always high. Now, when you take, it's always high. So, you're exposing your body to a high blood sugar, which is going to cause damage. So, with the pump, you can actually have that flexibility that at 4 o'clock when you're eating a snack, I can take 1 and 2 units to cover that snack. So, my pre-dinner is under control. So we, you know, when it comes to the insulin pen, they are very reluctant to take that extra shot of insulin. But here, when it comes to just pressing a button, they are very, very, you know, ready to actually take that extra insulin. So then, we actually encourage our patients to take at least 4 shots a day. 1 pre-breakfast, 1 pre-lunch, maybe in the morning as a mid-morning snack, especially if they are going to school and having a snack. Then 1 mid-morning, 1 pre-lunch, 1 in the evening and 1 pre-dinner. So that is what we encourage. As I told you, the active time of insulin is 4 to 6 hours. So make sure that you do not tell your patients to take insulin in that 4-hour gap. Suppose they have to take a correction, then their or pump will automatically calculate the active insulin time and give the correction based on what you have to press the ACT button. If you do not press the ACT button, the pump is not going to do anything on its own. Sometimes patients just go and set that and forget. Most often patients even forget to see, remember, they do not remember whether they've taken their previous shot. You know, they are not too sure. Then they can go back to bolus history and it tells you that when have you taken your last bolus. Another good feature in the pump is, you know, which is very good, because sometimes the pump, suppose you have not touched the pump for 8 hours, you've not given any command for 8 hours, the pump will actually set and, you know, it'll alarm you. Why is, suppose you're dead or you're lying in hypoglycemia or something, the pump alarms you that, you know, you've not touched your pump in 8 hours. So that's a very good feature. So there are so many features that are there with the pump which the patient needs to know about and explore.
Patient, because in Mumbai we have the affordable class of people, they wanted to upgrade themselves for a 5 lakh, 6 lakh. They spend the money, they buy the pump, but they use it as a normal pump only. So ultimately we don't, you know, pass on that benefit that you wanted to pass on to them, and finally we feel that he has not used pump perfectly. So it is my, you know, request to you all people that when you are recommending patient to you and you to the patient side, make sure that you all been well trained on pump features so that you can pass on that benefit to the patient very authoritatively. You know, we generally use this authority very often nowadays, because we have seen that if you don't give the authority statement to the patient, they will take it as a, you know, casual manner. Okay, they have recommended this, so I will use it like that. But if you very strict, okay, I want this to be done and has to be done, then patient will follow you. That we have seen in this last six and 7 years, that if you don't give the authoritative behavior with them, then they will be casual to the pump.
HbA1c is 13%.
Yeah.
13%.
Okay. Totally misuse.
We spoke to the patient not using the bolus wizard. Patient has been eating all meals out. Totally erratic, goes to a very prestigious school of Bombay, you know, so affordability is not a problem. Doesn't eat anything till 3:30 because there is no food given by the mother. Mother is sleeping when the child goes to school. And then 3:30 is the first meal of the day, which is a burger or a pizza, something that has to be ordered. Dinner is again something on those lines. Not checked the sugars for a year. And then when they did a CGMS, it was all haywire. A1C was 13%. Total daily dose, the child is 67 kilos and the amount of insulin the child is taking is nearly 120 units. That means way above the requirements.
He is eating out, you know, rooming, night out. He was just, you know, I would use this word, abusing the pump. We wanted to take out the pump, doctor advice says, and everything has been intervened, and then finally we got little bit improvement in that, not the fully, but little bit improvement. I visited him at home,
we
and
won't take names,
yeah, no,
but,
we don't have.
We then came into the picture and we've counseled the patient, and patient is now eating only home food. Okay, we told the mother that this cannot happen, because if this continues, you're in for some big trouble. The insulin dose is reduced from 120 units now to 65 units per day. Okay, patient is really good, and I'm sure we do the A1C now. We are looking at something below 7%, because this patient's sugar haven't crossed 160 in the last 2 months. Okay, so very important is counseling, because they tend to see that, you know, they can just take insulin. They don't even go to the doctor. I think that's another challenge we face, is patients stop going to the doctor once they are on the pump. That's why sometimes you have to tell patients, in fact, that's what the recommendation that we had given Medtronic was, that, you know, make sure that you do not give the patients consumables if they do not have a prescription from the doctor. Because patients only look at sugars being okay. What about all the other parameters? I mean, they have to visit the doctor. And most often when they go on the pump, then for years they don't see the doctor. Like this patient also did not see the doctor and then sends an email to the doctor with the CGMS report. What is the doctor going to do? So very important is encourage your patients, if you all are in touch, to see the doctor, because that is also important. You know, we are not only looking at sugars, we are looking at lipids, we are looking at blood pressure, we are looking at everything, complications. And that is very important. So, you know, I think that's, I don't know whether you'll have put that in action.
Yeah, we have.
It's very important. And I think they should not get their consumables if they do not have a prescription.
Yes, exactly.
At least once in 6 months. How much have you all kept that? 1 month, 3 months?
No, 4 months actually. We have in touch with our legal team now. If they don't get the prescription from doctor from last, 4 or 6 months, we will not supply the monthly consumable to them. So ultimately, they have to consult the doctor and come back to us and ask for the supplies.
Rakesh, because he'll be leaving now, so if you have any questions, please ask. This is the best time that you can
normally
ask.
We keep insulin in a cooler temperature. So when you go out with a pump, when you're mostly traveling out in a hot temperature, does the insulin spoil or?
Yeah. See, when our engineer team came here and the medical engineer came here, we asked the same question to them. They have told us the NoRapid with the pump, can work in between minus 5 degrees Celsius to 55 degrees Celsius for 7 to 8 days. So that was the answer given to us. But the patient to patient, we have got the different feedback. Like, you know, few patients who stay at the northern side where we have the very high, temperature also and cold also. So there we got the usage up to the 5 to 6 days on the pump. And for our region, like, you know, here we have the mixed temperature with the high humidity, we got a very good response. I don't know what the other patient could
have. We do face problems, especially when I have patients in Dubai. I do hear that during the high summer time.
Yeah. So we easily see the spoiled up insulin, and we see the bubble, precipitation form of that. So we can easily judge, okay, insulin got wasted, change the vial, like that.
Any doubt, when the patient is in doubt that the insulin may not be working, change.
Change it.
You know, that's the first thing to do, because you cannot take chances. We see sometimes lots of bubbles. Now that is also not good. That means they have to change their entire reservoir. The entire quick set has to be changed.
It's just that, like an instrument, we need to take care of it. It's somewhere there, it's proven, right?
Yeah, exactly, ma'am. It has to be taken. Like,
tell them what comes under warranty.
Yeah, button errors, electrical errors, then the breakable is not come under warranty. If you throw the pump, bone thrown out. If something, hit to the pump, and because of that pump is not working, so we don't consider it under the warranty, because it is human error intervention. Till the time we take the pump, take it to through the servicing team. If it is really, done by our end, we take it, and till the time we give the standby pump to the patient also. And if it is not been done, then we ask patient to, you have to take the new pump. But we don't charge the same amount, we charge the quite lesser amount from them. It has happened very rarely, but the pump, we have the specification. You can drop the pump from 6 feet distance, you can put the pump into 8 feet water depth for the 2 hours. Like that is been done. But generally we don't do it. It is like, I put it for 8 hours. 2 hours for 8 feet. Huata, working huata. Right now we don't have any insurance facility for the pump in the India. So we don't have that one. So patient has to pay from their own pocket.
How many people usually upgrade from basic to the middle? How many pumps in Bombay?
500+. India, we just recently touched 10,000 mark, just recently, numbers across India.
Can you change the battery?
Do you have to re-send the pump? No. See, if you don't use a pump for 8 days, and if you just keep that pump standby, then pump has to be reset. All the function, basal, bolus setting, bolus wizard setting has to be, reset. Or else, If you see that the battery has been going to get die and you change the battery, you don't have to reset the pump.
Another important thing is, which is of importance, is, see, these are buttons, right? You're constantly touching these buttons. Now what happens is our patients, they have big nails and then they are pressing it. So what happens, the buttons start cracking and then they stop working. Now this is not going to be covered. If that gets spoiled, you have to change your pump. So please tell your patients, this is a small point, but tell your patients not to keep big nails, because then you're actually damaging your pump.
Or else use a properly, use your thumb properly, or the fingers properly.
Connect with the laptop or something like that.
For the CGMS, that will come to it. This is only pump. Pump does not record the thing. Only that recorder will do. It will only transmit. So here you will see a graph, and then it will show you an upward, two arrows upwards or two arrows downwards. Two arrows means it is really
drastically
fast.
Drastically
so you
dropping.
Have to take corrective action. Maybe you have to set your bases lower or eat something, but it is warning you that in the next 1-2 hours it is going to go low.
Can we change the settings multiple times in the day?
Yes, you can.
Change it plenty of times.
But we wouldn't encourage that because that's not something which is right. I think that is something you should tell your patient, not tell too much to your patients, because I think they should, you know, otherwise then we've had patients who've taken 35 units of insulin at within a span of 15 minutes and gone into severe hypoglycemia. We've had a girl who's 17, 18. Okay, and then called up because she was obviously at a friend's house and she kept eating, kept taking insulin, not using the bolus either. Mother was in she was not in Bombay, she was in Bhopal or somewhere. And then they called up the Medtronic person, he stays in Panvel or Khargar. For him to come from there to Goregaon, that Royal Palms, it's obviously going to take time, the child is unconscious. So very important is please focus on that, you know, that 4 hours, you cannot keep taking insulin. Whatever has to be taken. If you do not know how much you're going to eat, you might as well eat and then you take later. Or you take only half and take half later on, but not all at one time. Because that patient can go into severe, it can be very dangerous. So that's why we don't mind the hyperglycemia, but we do not want the hypoglycemia. And with pump, we've seen that the incidences of hypoglycemia are more or less nullified. And if the person uses it well, we've seen A1C, especially for pregnant women, we've seen fantastic results. We've had patients who delivered with an A1C of 6% throughout pregnancy. So it's fantastic.
So after like 7 years, when the battery life of this this thing is over, people do upgrade to another pump? Or?
Yeah, they upgrade to the next pump. Generally, they don't wait for 7 years. They buy, upgrade it in 4 or 5 years only, because it is under a warranty. So they know that they will get less depreciation on their current this one.
So suppose if this is the basic one. So if they upgrade into the new one, will they pay 5 lakh or?
No, their current pricing will be deducted from 5 lakh. Suppose you buy pump for 2 lakh rupees and you want to have a 5 lakh and 50. So I will deduct 2 lakh from the 50.
It's like your car. How would you buy a car?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It is a nice question because patient may ask them, no.
India pumps. Yeah. There are people who sold.
Yeah, very good question. For rental, we charge 2,500 rupees. Nominal fee, 2,500 per month.
One good news, there is one course called Certified Pump Educator course. Certified. See, what we are doing today is not a trailer also, right? So if you don't understand anything, right? If you don't feel comfortable, right? Or if you don't feel confident, right? It doesn't matter. Even if you go and ask some good MD doctor and ask certain few questions, right? What you have learned today, right? He will not understand. I mean it. He will not answer, that is 100% sure, but he will not understand also. If you asked him, what is insulin carb ratio or insulin sensitivity factor, what is that? Right? Or he will ask, this much carb and this much insulin, he will say, what is that? So it is something like, new cell phone, which my 6-year-old son is using very comfortably, right? And if I tell him, he will show, okay, right. And I don't understand only, right? So that is a technology, it will happen, right? But if you're serious, right, then you have to take a course of Certified Pump Educator course. Is 1 day course?
Yeah, 1 day.
It's a certified pump trainer course. I'm the lead trainer for it, so I take it pan-India, morning to evening. So we start at 9, it ends at 6, it has an examination. You have to score 85% in the exam. Okay, so that is a mandatory thing. You do not get the certificate till you do not see 2 people being put on the pump, and you do not put 2 people on the pump. So the certificate doesn't come easily. You have to put 2 people on the pump, and you have to see 2 people being put on the pump. Once we are happy with that, so you'll have an examiner who will come and see. Once you all qualify in the exam as well as this practical aspect,
then you get a certified pump trainer certificate, which is valid for 1 year, and then you will have to do an advanced, and every year there will be an advancement, and then you have to keep applying for registration again and again. So that is a CPT program. We've done CPT in Bombay, Chennai, Pune, and Cochin,
yeah.
We've done. So Delhi we've done. So these are the areas where we've trained. And so if any of y'all are interested, maybe y'all can send me your names, and then we can maybe request Medtronic to do this program for you.
So there is a lot of...
We'll let you know that, but right now y'all can send your names, maybe we'll have a discussion, because we do not have it for such large groups. Usually in our pump training programs, we have a smaller group, because it is more...
Hands-on.
So we'll have to speak to Medtronic and maybe see if we can do it in 2 batches.
And it is a serious thing, you know, it is not...
Today
we are giving, you know, it is like a test drive, you know. Test drive doesn't mean that, right, that you will own the car and... it is like a GPRS, you know, global positioning system, you know. So some reading, it keeps you telling you, know, that you drive this way, right? So something like that technology is available, but for that you have to learn that, right? So Rakesh, thanks a lot for your time.
Right. We have come up to here in a very progressive manner, and after that, we need some reversal. So there is a progress in terms of technology, and there is a deterioration in terms of lifestyle. Following mechanization and industrialization, everything has changed in terms of our food, activity, thought process, stress levels, everything has changed, right? So those requires reversal. So, if you combine, or if we combine, lifestyle changes as a primary and technology add on, what is happening, Cheryl very clearly mentioned that somebody is on a pump but with a worse lifestyle. So, in that bargain, pump will not do any harm, pump will not do any good to him. And when pump is misused or abused, there is a harm. So remember one slide that I keep on talking, American Diabetic Association 2015 recommendations, right? You Google it, right? Now you people are good at Google, right? So you go in Google images, American Diabetes Association 2015 treatment guideline, and you will see one slide. It is a green frame. Now what is added in that compared to last year? Weight control, diet, exercise and activity, and education. Education is added this year, and it is presumed that execution will be there, because without execution, education doesn't have meaning. And green frame is a lifestyle, and in that so many medications are there. So the technology, if covered by lifestyle work, if it is technology is open, it is a dangerous, disastrous. Very clear on this point. In this lecture, we were supposed to cover pens, because there is change in the insulin, newer insulins, change in the devices, newer pens, then change in monitoring system, that is CGMS, and change in insulin delivery system, right? So we have already covered pens, right? So we'll skip those slides, insulin devices. Now we have talked about the CGMS, but now we will see, you know, some reports of the CGMS, and that we will realize that what CGMS is, MS is, right? But in that there are 3 things which we must know, that something goes inside, something is connected, and then after 4 days or 6 days you get the data which you can download, and you can see some results like this, right? So that is a retrospective, and there is online real time that we already talked. Now, what is the advantage? The first advantage we have seen, maximum 7 readings against 288 reading per day multiplied by number of days, and with those readings we can get so many patterns. This reading gives you instant at that moment, or it will give you pattern of 7. CGMS will give pattern of 288. Camera mein pixels hota hai na, higher pixels better clarity, no. So CGMS is of higher pixel in terms of blood sugar monitoring. Now, before the era of CGMS, right, monitoring was a nightmare, right? It was not possible only, right? But after CGMS, patient knew what they are doing and what they are suffering, and doctors also, the health team understood what is happening. And the surprises were, when sugars were normal on regular monitoring, glycohemoglobin was normal, but patients were suffering from complications. And with the help of CGMS, we knew something new called glucose variability, ups and downs. That was possible to know only with the help of CGMS, and that was not happening with the finger sticks and the glycohemoglobin. And all the mortalities and the morbidities in terms of the organ damage are proportional to the glucose variability. There is enough data. So this is how CGMS helps. Now, it has a short term benefits and it has a long term benefits. What is a short term benefit? You can adjust the dose immediately, on the spot, immediately, right? In the long term, once you know how fixing occurs, right, you can give proper dosages and the glycohemoglobin starts improving. If the glycohemoglobin is 7, eye damage, kidney damage and nerve damage is a more than 1. When CGMS, this GHB 8, 2 times, 9, 5, 4 and 3 times, 10, 8, 6 and 4, 12, 9, 6 and 20, 15 and 8. So, when you say glycohemoglobin, my glycohemoglobin is a 10. So, what does it touch your head? If I say my glycohemoglobin is 10, normal 7 hona chahiye, 10 hai, 10 hai toh kya ho gaya? If as a diabetes educator, if you say that with the glycohemoglobin 10, eye damage chances 8 times more, kidney 6 times and nerve damage 4 times. Does it make some sense? And now how will you achieve normal? By keeping all the blood sugar before and after meal normal. So, glycohemoglobin is an average of blood sugar before and after meal, right? 70 to 10, correct? Meter readings, and the glyco is 7. CGMS, you see something like this. So, this is high above normal, this is low below normal, high, right? Now, these areas are not covered by cell monitoring, and these areas are covered by blood sugar. In further, we will see. Now, here is the highest excursion, right? And 50% of the normal, right? So, we feel good, right? And this is the excursion missed. So, out of 24 hours, 14 hours are outside. So, with these two readings, we think that we are fine, but actually we are not. These are different colors, purple, green, red, magenta, and this is the average. So, in this chart we see reading on 29, 30, 1st, 2nd, and this broken line is average. So, now you see whatever is our ups. So most of the days and most of the time the person is out of the control. Now if person has kept the diary that what were the activities, what was the food and what was the stress level on this particular day, he can correlate with the CGMS. So that's why logbook becomes very important, right? CGMS of one lady called Neela Kale, she is a type 2 diabetic on insulin for a long time. She has undergone coronary bypass surgery. She has some nephropathy and she will do some blood sugars once in a while and try to adjust her dosages, and she herself is a doctor. Try to adjust. So we did her CGMS and she realized that whatever she was doing, it was good here, but it was totally out of control. Right? This one chart is enough to make you understand that the things are not good. Pie diagram. So the yellow means more than 140. The target, upper target is 140. So on each day, you know, on Wednesday, all the readings were out. Thursday, more than 75%. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So most of the days, most of the time, blood sugars are out of control. Now, is it possible to conclude with the help of finger sticks? No, it is possible only in this manner. Now, this daily summary has to be correlated with the diet, with the activity and the stress, because on that previous slide you see so many things, but here you can correlate and make understanding. Now, see, these are the readings taken by patient, finger stick, right? Do you see how nicely they are matching? Right? So, finger stick and CGMS almost always matches, excepting the delay, but the delay should not be considered because you are going in the time continuously, right? So the delay doesn't matter. You realize the value of this, and how much does it cost? One good CGMS costs say 5,000, right? So 5,000 for 5 days, 1,000 per day, 1,000 divided by 288, 3.5 rupees per test. What is one finger sticks cost? 1 AGT kitna? 50. You should know cost of all the meters, all the strips, spirit, lancet. As an educator, you should know. You should have total idea, right? The cheapest will be 15 rupees per finger stick. And here 4, right? So it is 4 times cheaper. And for 288 pricks against one prick, and there's many lancets. Suppose I use one lancet for 10 pricks, right? So at least 28 lancets will go, and the average cost of lancet is at least 10 rupees. So how many? 300 rupees to khali lancet ka hi ho gaya, right? So as per the convenience and the amount of information given, this is the cheapest. Are you convinced or not? If you are not convinced, tell me, right? What I am showing you is a fact, right? So this conviction should be there in your mind when you are asking for CGMS. So tumko lagega 5000 rupees ka kharcha kyun karne ka, but you are getting something, right, which you will never get. Overlay by meal event, breakfast, lunch and dinner, right? So what is happening? Breakfast, before breakfast, after, before lunch, after, before dinner, after. So you are getting the clear cut picture. Now all the reading which are high before meal, right, they require correction of what? Basal. And all the reports which are high after meal, they require correction of bolus. This much is clear, right? So basal bolus idea becomes very clear on the basis of this. And here is a beautiful presentation, right? Before breakfast, all the readings are bad. after breakfast all are bad, before lunch, after lunch, before and dinner, after dinner there was no data, but evening all are bad. So practically all the blood sugars are out of control and she requires a very good first control on the basal and then on bolus. Do you remember some word like 48 basals, right? 4 bolus. Now when you give insulin, single prick, right? You give one insulin at a fixed time, it will go up and come down. So go up in half hour and come down, and this is a fix. Chhod diya bas. You can't take it back. Against when you give with the pump, pump can give this much here, this much here, this much here, this much, because you can set it, right? So against one prick and one setting, you have this much. Now when you are talking about the basal, this is basal. Mind mein kuch aisa picture hona chahiye, what is basal, right? That when you give it at 0 hour, after 2 hours action will start, slowly it will come at the 8 hours and slowly it will come down in 24 hours. That's it. Now what is 48? You can change basal here, 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 basal every time. Now if my before breakfast is coming very high, right? This is my breakfast, 8 o'clock, right? Blood sugars are very high, so I can increase my basal 8 to 4 in the morning. From here I can make it this much. I can adjust. Now I am getting lot of low sugar before lunch. This is my lunch, right? I am getting low. So I can reduce my basal from this much, I can bring out this. Designer saadi sunai? Huh? Designer cloth sunai? Ki itna dikhega bas. Ya itna nahi dikhega. Kuch dikhega. Use the same principle of designer by imagining that you can change this shape in any manner that you want. Right? So every half an hour you can change the basal by proper programming. Now if you feel that this is wrong, then you can stop that. So there is called function called suspend. During that suspend you want to increase, you can increase, reduce, you can stop, which cannot happen with a single prick, it can happen here. I'm clearing, because when when you are listening, you know, to Rakesh and Cheryl, right, I was looking at you and ekdam hathoda jaisa lagta tha. 48 basal kya karne gaye 48 basal ko. So this is the change, right, that you can create. You know mixed art 30-70, meaning thereby 30% works like a short acting, 70% works like a long acting, right? Diya diya bas baat khatam hai. Now as per this, person has to have the food, have the activity. Not possible, not possible. But here you can change in any manner you want. So here this is the bolus you are changing, this is basal you are changing. Now what body does, body produces continuous basal round the clock. And ye breakfast thoda zyada hai to ye le liya, beech mein thoda khaya hai, dinner mein hai. Body will keep on checking, keep on giving, right? Now that can be made possible by continuous glucose monitoring and pump, shadi, right? Bolta jayega ki zyada hai. And Cheryl said very good thing, you know, about the trend. Now see here, the trend is up, right? And here trend is down, right? So similarly, if the lifestyle is reasonably fixed, proper time of breakfast, lunch, evening snack and a dinner, then this will work out. But in some case where lifestyle is not fixed, suppose there is a policeman or a firefighter, right? Or there are irregular duties that that back office duty in the night, you know, ki when USA ka call kitne kabhi aa jayenge malum hi nahi padta, right? You are working, means the things are, lifestyle is not under your control in a command. At that time this system will be at your rescue, and that is how you are going to adjust all this. Now what was very important in that, we have written three readings are important: before breakfast, before lunch and before dinner. Have you read that carefully? Blood sugar before breakfast, even if you are on a pump, why it is important? Because if your readings are very high before starting food, right, and on the top of that you are going to have food, and on the top of that you are going to have a party, right? Blood sugar is 300, target is 100, it is high by 200, on the top of that you are going to have a party now, and that is 4-hour party. So for such thing, insulin pump is a eye opener and answer. Otherwise what will you do, you know? You tell me, with such a high, what will you do? Am I giving you answer, or am I fighting a good case in favor of a pump or not? Right? Because when either you are limited by a disease or limited by a lifestyle, this is the answer. This was the first pump. But still today it is a much powerful pump than what we have. Why? What is the beauty of this pump? Sharir, you know what is the beauty of this pump? What was the beauty of this pump? It had two reservoirs, one for insulin and one for glucagon. So there is a hypo, there will be suspension of insulin, and there will be delivery of glucagon, which this pump doesn't have. Insulin is produced by beta cell, and it travels, it enters the venous circulation, and it is secreted in a hepatic vein. Whatever insulin we are giving, it is subcutaneous. So the original thing which will come will have a ability to deliver in the hepatic vein, then it will match. Second, sensor to know the blood sugar, and a device to give glucose and a glucagon, then it is a complete pump. Even with the subcutaneous we have traveled far, and we have proven good results, right? What are the candidates, you know, who can be benefited, you know? But the one of the most important thing are some technical indications, right? Brittle diabetes or a brittle lifestyle, pregnancy, hypoglycemia unawareness, severe peripheral neuropathy or diabetes complication, and gastroparesis, when there is a dumping of food and they get severe hypoglycemias, right? So these are the indications, the clinical indications which are very important. What are the things required? I will not say IIM or MBA education. I say common sense education. Abhi kitne paas mobile hai? Kitne logon ke paas mobile hai? Kisne ke paas mobile nahi hai? Right? Koi salesman ne aapko becha hai? Did you have any salesman, you know, pleading you ke chalo bhai mobile kharido? Hamara sales ekdam down ho gaya. Acha. Second point, who taught you mobile? Have you attended any class? It has happened, no? Similarly, pump education should become like a mobile education, right? At least among the diabetes educators. And there has to be motivation. And what is a motivation? Freedom. Two types of freedom: freedom in lifestyle and freedom in disease. So freedom in disease in spite of lifestyle. So that is a motivation. Adherence to the diet. Kerosene डालेगा, Mercedes बिगड़ जाएगा. इतना याद रखने का. एक ही dialogue diet के लिए काफी है. Put a kerosene, Mercedes will not work. Supportive family. This is one of the most important thing. Right? Otherwise people will say कि 24 घंटा तेरा diabetes का ही झंझट है. It is very demeaning, you know. It's very difficult, you know, in that family. And he should be, just as you count insulin, no? Now see one thing. I want everybody to focus on this. Idli kisko ne khilaya mere ko? Abhi hai? Now we'll see the experiment. Give me one idli. All dieticians and going to practice like a dietitian. Kitna vajan hai iska? Why guess?
50.
Right? Now, see, I am going to give you a very different message, right? Please pay attention. You said?
35.
And put your hand and say what I was going to say. Did not say, right? But one scale, once used, right? अभी सबके दिमाग में बैठेगा ऐसा इडली देखेगा तो 15 ग्राम बोलने का. सो व्हेन पर्सन मेजर्स व्हाट एवर फूड आर्टिकल ही और शी टेक्स फॉर अ ब्रेकफास्ट लंच एंड डिनर राइट एंड मैचिस विद द ब्लड शुगर एंड इंसुलिन राइट सो सम अकाउंट सेट्स इन एंड आई एम गोइंग टू मेक दिस आइटम कंपल्सरी टू ऑल द पेशेंट्स because it removes so many doubts, if and buts, right? So just as you see, we are talking about change in insulin dose by how much? 0.025 unit? Huh? Am I right? Did we hear clearly? We measure insulin to 0.025 unit, but when it idli comes, 15, 30, 35, 50. And on the basis of that, we calculate carbohydrate insulin ratio. And on the basis of that, we adjust the insulin. But what is our base? Base is wrong. Now, in this idli, how much will be the water? How much will be rice? And how much will be udat? Idli is made up of rice, udad, water, how much will be the salt, how much will be the curd, because udad and curd will decide protein part. Now, if you have two part rice and one part udad, it will be high carb. It will be, when you have one part rice, one part udad, it will be equal. And suppose you use more udad, then it will be high protein. Now, with this 15 gram cup 50 gram, you see how change thing, right? You think that it is a 50 gram idli. You think that idli is a high carb item, right? And adjust the bolus for a high. And for a 50 gram, what will happen? Hypo. Abhi bole pump use karta hai, wizard use karta hai, to bhi hypo hota hai. So we say, you know, highly educated. So the education is in terms of using weighing scale and using ingredients. Count once. Because my idli pattern is fixed, right? If my wife is using two part rice and one part udad, for life she is going to use like that. That is not going. But when I go outside, it will be different. Now I will tell you one data share, it is worth sharing. They did one study of nitrogen content or say protein content of wheat. One group in England and one group in Canada. Canadian wheat was 32 percent protein and Canadian wheat, and English wheat was just half. So they have concluded that the protein content depends on the nature of the soil and nurture. So don't take any book on diet as a final, because the food values change as per the soil. So at that time only one thing fixed with us, weighing scale and Indian data, right? No American data, Indian data in weighing scale, and then we will do fine tuning of insulin. See, what I am trying to show you, there are so many factors and how much role you can play and how much blunders we are doing. Clear cut example, right? This is a diabetes complication control trial, and in this trial they were on intensive regime, 7 blood sugars per day for more than 10 years this trial lasted, and they have shown reduction in neuropathy, retinopathy and nephropathy, insulin regime, and this is a pump. So the pump scored over all the multi-dose regimes. We saw, right, this GHB7, and you see ups and downs. You have seen monofilament? You have touched that monofilament, right? When you press that monofilament, what feeling you get? What feeling you get? Same feeling you get when it is inserted. When you get the experience, right, you get convinced. Airbag. Right? And what does the airbag do? When there is sudden, otherwise your spine will be crushed. Spine will be crushed. I mean ribs will be crushed, right? This protects you, right? Similarly, low sugar, it predicts the trend and it protects you. You remember that during hypoglycemia lecture, I showed that Niagara fall. You remember that Niagara fall slide? You remember that, no?
Yes.
Niagara fall slide? Because from your face I can make out that whether you remember or not. So with that, low glucose suspend thing came, you know, that you don't go in that. See, CGMS, continuous glucose monitoring system, works in 3 manner, right? Primary, secondary and tertiary. What is the primary manner? Just to find out whether the sugars are under good control or not, just trial basis, right? And you get the knowledge from that. After trying that, you try to adjust, right? The things are not working, so you do continuous CGMS and continuous monitoring. Right, in real life, and you see how the things are working, right, and that will give you better knowledge. That's over. But what is called global positioning system, GPS, right? You are going to new area, right? You have GPS, right? Do you have to stop the car or ki wo 10 number ka road kidhar hai aisa puchna padta hai? It tells you, no? If you miss, then it relocates, but it takes you to that particular place by a standard system, alright. Now when you are travelling on the same road again and again and again, you use that GPS system? No. Now you know that, it has become a part of you, right? Now the road is dug up and now new road is there, you again start that GPS system on that day, right? So CGMS is in 3 manner: diagnostic initially, then in real time, and then throughout the life. Just as there is insulin pump, there is a CGMS. At the moment, what is very important? What is very important in CGMS and monitoring system? Cost and convenience, right? Now, I said 10 years back, if somebody says, right, you can take as many pictures as possible. You can download, you can take the video. Pick up the phone, take the video and mail it. Why it has become? People have accepted the technology. People have used the technology like anything, and it has become cheap. Now, I remember when I was a houseman at around 1978-79, the blood glucose meter was this much size, itna box jaisa, right? And you have to warm it, you know, for 5 minutes before you do the blood test. And at that time, the cost of strip was around 15 or 16 rupees. I am talking 1980. It was not cheap, right? And now, blood sugar khujde se nikal ke cut karke khaye, samajh bhi nahi aata, right? So, more people use it, more accept it, then the cost will come down. Now, I'll answer your question in a different manner. That suppose person develops a retinopathy, the amount of money that he will invest for laser therapy and eye surgery goes in lakhs, or for that matter any coronary event, he will spend in lakhs, or renal failure, the cost, suppose person undergoes dialysis twice a week, and if you take a very reasonable dialysis center, then 8 days are wasted twice a week, then 8 days of person accompanying are wasted, at least half a day for dialysis, so at least 12,000. Minimum, right? Minimum. Then injection erythropoietin, all other medications, doctor's charges,
blood test,
and slow and progressive deterioration in spite of this. If you go for one good amputation, at least a lakh of a rupee. Now, these things occur at the fag end of the story, and they are compulsory. And CGMS and pump therapy is at the start, when you do not have any trouble. but that is the time to invest in it. So you have two ways of long-term, short-term investment and long-term investment. Complication is a short-term investment, and the health is a long-term investment. Where you want to put is a challenge, or a choice, I will say. 5.5 lakh ka latest pump is a costly item, or nano gadi 3 lakh rupees ka sasta. Now this is a mindset, and here I am telling you the basic issue, that people think that the health is given free of the cost, it will remain throughout their life, and it will remain without investing anything in it. This is a mindset, and whenever you have to spend for your health, right, it pinches. It's a mindset, and when you have to spend 5 lakh, it has to pinch like 5 lakh, and when you have to spend, you know, 10-12 thousand, it has to pinch like 10-12 thousand. But again, that if you are shown that instead of spending in lakh, these thousands are good, then people are happy. So you have to show the advantage versus, you know, the bad picture. So here I end up with a one slogan called happiness, right? So the CGMS and insulin therapy has a two component, healthiness or a happiness. CGMS and insulin pump therapy can be out of a choice or out of compulsion. I haven't got the slide, but I have taken one slide was, you know, people are coming down by parachute in a war. Then second slide is people are coming down in a drought area, or the people flood area, right, to help somebody. And third slide was, you know, people are coming down out of fun. So the insulin pump therapy can be fun, or insulin pump therapy can be out of frustration, right? How you take it, when you take it, that is the issue. Okay, so I think we complete our last class. Now I have a one minute presentation for everybody before we leave, right? Everybody will come
after passing out from SVT. There are few things that we get to know in this class, so this will help in getting better outcome with the patients. That's the practical knowledge we get in this class.
With the knowledge from this class, I would like to help out my family members, because that is the biggest challenge I face, to convince them with a lot of practical examples that have been shared by the professors.
Okay, with the amount of knowledge gained in this lecture, I would first utilize it with my family members, make sure that they have a better life, and then use it on the patients who come to me.
This course has really helped me to modify the lifestyle of my entire family, friends. I can always help them, my neighbors, and of course, if I'm practicing in future, my patients. Thank you.
Through this course, we've got practical knowledge, which has really helped me in implementing it when I work or when I come in contact with any patient. And I'm already implementing because I'm already working with Cheryl Ma'am, so it's fun.
Really glad that I took up this course. I really didn't know about diabetes in depth. This course really helped me to know, like get more knowledge about diabetes and how to manage patients and how to handle, so, you know, like diabetics and all that. So yes, definitely I'm going to help my family members first and then practice with my patients.
And I will try best to put it in my practice. My family, since my father attended the camp, and he was really glad, and he just told me, sir is very nice. So, and the knowledge he gained from it, he was never following anything like properly. So now he started following.
With this knowledge, first it is for my younger sister. She is diabetic type 1. So first I'll help her, like I'm helping her already, and then in my practice as well.
The first thing which I would like to do with the education or the knowledge which I have gained here is to reduce the anxiety which is associated with diabetes, and I would also like make the patients feel at ease, because mindful healing is also equally important as compared to the medications, etc.
Practical knowledge I got in this course, I would really help my mom. She is diabetic. Actually, I'm helping her now also in her diet and all, and her sugar's really gone down. So obviously doctors are also associated, so I will help my patients also likewise.
From the amount of knowledge that I gained here, I have been able to diagnose my own family members from pre-diabetes. My own husband is pre-diabetic. He even attended the camp. So I would like to thank for all the information and amount of knowledge that I have got in this lecture. Thank you.
This knowledge, I would like to bring happiness in as many patients I counsel, because this has given a hands-on experience and a practical information adding on to my career skills.
It's a very good course, and I'll use this knowledge in my professional life.
Already being a fitness consultant, and after doing this course, I really feel empowered with this in-depth knowledge of diabetes, and I'm sure I will make a difference in my clients' personal lifestyle and eating habits. Yes, and I have also just started freelancing and taking classes, which includes yoga, tai chi, pilates, and strength training. And I'm sure the clients which I get, and if somebody's diabetic, I can surely help them in their diet and lifestyle too.
Doing this course, this knowledge what I've got from here, which is I'm going to definitely using in my diabetes practice, which is really helping my ongoing patients. Thank you.
This course has helped me upgrade my knowledge, and much in simplified way. I know the topics now, and even the insulin thing, which was a bit difficult for me to understand. And I'll definitely help and implement this knowledge to my patients and my family members.
This course has added to the knowledge of diabetes, and it will definitely help me in better counseling patients.
Knowing about diabetes here was an eye-opener for me. We got to know so much about the foot care and the eye care that we got to know here. Knowledge is like, in my opinion, the flame of candlelight. The more you spread it, the more illuminated the area becomes. And that is what I intend to do. I intend to spread the word wherever I go, as in take sessions maybe tomorrow or get into teaching or whatever. But I want people to be aware, and that's what I would be doing after I learn whatever I did from here. Thank you.
This course has really been, I've gained a lot from this course, and I'm glad I was a part here. Also, the best part would be today, we got to know more about the latest technologies. So I think that was a great class. Also, the other interactive sessions that we've had. So there's been a lot that this course has, taught me, and I hope to implement the same when I am interacting with my patients and help them benefit from the same. Thank you.
Through this course, I got to learn many more things, like insulin syringes. I can still feel the whatever we felt when we practically saw those in our practice. But then one more thing I would like to add is the patient which I got in my camp, his readings were very high, and then through this course, whatever I have learned, so I try implementing it, and then when I later consulted him, so I can within 15 days his readings were in control. So he was quite happy with sir and the diet which I planned and all. So he was quite happy and even curious to meet sir again. So he was asking me when is other camp. So it is only possible through this course only. Thank you.
The knowledge which I gained from this course helped me make changes in my own lifestyle. And the other thing which I gained from this is I could understand my patients better through the live examples which he had at the camp. And it also helped me spread awareness in my family and friends.
I'm really glad to be a part of this course, and I'm surely going to implement the knowledge when I work.
This course was really very helpful for me, as it helped to gain my knowledge regarding the field of diabetes, as it was always my interest subject. And it also helped me to get a lot of counseling skills, which will help me in further counseling of the patients. Thank you.
this course has added a lot to my knowledge, and I'll like to implement on my father because he's a diabetic patient.
The practical knowledge which I have gained in this course about healthy lifestyle and lifestyle disorder are helping me to educate my family members and to make them aware of the disorders and the risk factor which they may face if they do not follow a healthy lifestyle.
With the knowledge which I have gained through this course, I'll utilize this in my practicing and help my patients to lead a healthy and happier life.
This course has helped me clear the concepts of diabetes and has helped me to have a better insight on the subject on various topics in diabetes, and it will definitely help me in my further practice on my patients as well as my family.
This course has not only helped in enlightening us with the diabetes, but even with how to manage other lifestyle disorders also, and even how to counsel patients and how to manage them and how to reduce their anxieties. Thank you.
Actually, I know few diabetic patients who really don't know much about, they don't have knowledge about this diabetes, how to manage them. So firstly, I want to help them with this knowledge which I have learned, and also especially the technologies which are upcoming.
The knowledge which I have gained from this course, I'll surely try to implement on my patients, and also I've already implemented on my mother. And she has got a good result, and from this course, I've tried to explain her and convince her in much more better way.
This course has helped me a lot and will help me in future also with my patients, family members and relatives. Thank you.
I have gained a lot of knowledge from this course. I will try to implement in my practice.
This course helps us very lot. It will help us to know very well techniques, and it will help us to know how to awareness techniques and counseling for my patients. It will help us a lot.
Today, me and Cheryl, we both, shall you join us? I don't know what type of exams we will be conducting for you and how we will be grading you, right? But today was our exam. Today was my and Cheryl's exam. That what change we thought of and what effort we attempted, you know. And that's why I say you don't think, it should come right from your within, inner. And I am happy. Now I invite all of you, this particular batch, to join for one business partnership. You remember those four words I used in the first lecture? Learn. Who remembers four words? Four words, you know, that was my first lecture. Learn, earn. It ends with N. Fun and gun. Right. If you don't do all this, somebody will do it. Right? And they will be ahead of you. So that's the gun. Was there any fun during all these classes?
Yes.
Seeing those videos? Funny examples or dangerous examples? Candles? Camp? Candles? Lighting candles, you know? Right? All those, right? Now, learn has occurred because it was a learning class. Now, where is the earn? So, now I invite you, all of you, for one project. Utsavi will be our coordinator. And the Cheryl will be our advisor in that. For next one week, you take a picture of everything that you eat. Breakfast, lunch, whatever chatter patter, and dinner. Right? When you are at home, don't believe your skill, but वेट और उसके नीचे अपना व्हाट्सएप में ही डालो, अपने को ही व्हाट्सएप करो. राइट, सपोज आई हैव से टू इडली एंड चटनी, राइट, देन चटनी शुड बी इन दैट स्कूप 5 ml वाला, एंड इडली शुड बी वेट, एंड आस्क योर मॉम कि व्हाट, हाउ मच राइस एंड हाउ मच उड़द. सो स्टार्ट विद द ड्राई वेट, कुक्ड वेट, पोर्शन वेट, right, And we'll email Excel sheet. We'll email one Excel sheet. And from your standard books, NIN or Dr. Mohan's Atlas, right? Put the value. Right? Whatever values you can put, right? And within a week, right, be conversant visually. Kisme itna carb hai. Just look at it. Your own food, right? Not patient's food, right? And we will come out with one beautiful Excel sheet. Right? That Excel sheet we will email, right? So on left hand side there will be picture. And right hand side will be weight and ingredients. I assure you, I promise you, that with this exercise over a week, and if you do it for 3 weeks, right, it will become a habit at the end of the month. Because once you have done it, right, see, I have used this scale. So condition, dekho kya. For last couple of years at my home, right, we don't believe, you know, ke itna hoega. Rakh ke dekh lene ka. Simple hai, right? And usko baad mein multiply karne ka hai, no? Value se. You immediately know, right? So let us do, all of us, say 40 or plus, right, participants. Do it for your own self, right? And then we will pull that data. Once you pull that data, right, you will get different values, right? Drop-down menu jaisa ho jayega. Then we'll tell some application wala to make it little easier. How to use that very powerfully. Now I am giving you the business aspect. You are asking patient, no, ki kitna khata hai? Wo bolta hai ki ye bore. Kuch bhi wo bol deta hai. Aur hum kuch bhi likh lete hain. Aur uspe se kuch bhi calculation aata hai. Kaisa calculation? 15 gram, 30 gram, 35 gram, 50 gram, kuch bhi. Again that, if you are having a picture, he can't lie, no? Breakfast mein kya khaya? Patient to picture bhejega na, wo jhoot to nahi bolega. Right? Against picture you have values, so your consultation will become more solid, powerful. Right? And mind you, patient doesn't mind sending couple of pictures, but if you tell him to write down, he will think twice. उसमें बोला क्या खाए उसका नाम नीचे लिखना एंड इफ पॉसिबल अमाउंट राइट आई एम वेरी श्योर दैट विद इन अ मंथ वी कैन कम आउट विद अ ब्यूटिफुल डेटा एंड दैट वी कैन पब्लिश इन सम जर्नल ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ दिस एज अ टीम राइट एंड यू पीपल विल बी यू नो सब्जेक्ट्स and control. And you will only say, you know, that by just thinking and writing, we would have calculated this much. But by with picture, we calculated this much. And with weighing, we have. So there is a refining. Right? And with this refining, the application will become. And I think it will be a very powerful way of, you know, measuring and advising. I think it can change the way of advising, you know. Then what grade of dietitian you are doesn't matter, because you are giving service, right? So let us do it. Usavi, you have email ID. So from my side, I am going to send you two emails. One is on a junk food. At least you will get, you know, ready list of junk food. You remembered I have used two words about the food, Amrut and poison. Remember those, Dad? So these two sheets will come. One will be Amrut and one will be poison. And when you are eating also, you have to put it in these two categories. Right? And start doing it. And within a month, let us see how. But the photograph, what you take from your camera on your WhatsApp, you just have to download, and then a week's plan, right?
Easter time, we'll have a lot of delicacies, so at least we'll get more and more options, and make sure you don't repeat the items so that you know you have enough database.
And another thing which I had in mind, what Cheryl says, right, that culture-based, or I will not say religion-based, but, you know, practice-based, you know, practice-based food, you know, that Parsi will eat regularly on this, Saturday, Sunday, this, on his festivals, this, and when he will have a community, Parsi community party, he will use it, right? Then the Gujarati will do this, Jain will do this, Mohammedan will do this, Christian will do this, right? Everybody will do. Now, if the ready reckoner lists are there, the diet counseling can become very powerful. It can become absolutely powerful because, you know, the body language changes. When you talk to Parsi about Dhansak, right? He is very happy. Okay, you sink, you know. You sink very clearly, you know. Or Sindhi ko papad se start karenge. So, ye achha doctor hai. Koki and papad. And Goani se fried fish se baat karenge. He is our person, right? Done. Your job is done, you know. Right. So, this should be, you know, first I said something with me, what I am doing, right? And in that you put that what is your background, right? And then we'll proceed further. But I want this group, you know, to work further, you know. And I'll tell you, our publication is the greatest earning beyond money. Our publication, right? Because for that publication, we have to work hard. And when we work hard, our practice and way of doing changes. Right? And that, the money will be the last part. But it has to come. Okay?
And we'll be in touch. So at least, you know, whatever new things. Like there's so much new coming. In fact, y'all must have read the papers. There's a study done on rice and cooking it with coconut oil and eating it the next day. We all know about resistant starch. So again, you know, is like we can actually see whether it really works with our patients. And maybe when we do a CGM, or you know, even when they do a finger prick, again, quantity, glycemic load, all that we have to see. Are we losing out on any nutrients? You know, so even those things, because we're talking about the positive side, but are we also looking at the other parts that could have happened? So maybe, you know, constantly keeping in touch, maybe doing these things, because then we will become a very strong group, and at least it will help all our patients. It's not something, and always remember, like at least I have always kept that in mind, that if you share knowledge, I don't think I am worried about it. It only increases and you learn more, and the more you share, the more your patients benefit. And there are enough patients. I don't think any of us needs to get insecure. We have more than 6 million people with diabetes and we have more than 7.7 million people with pre-diabetes. So each one of us has enough patients that we have to worry that if we share our knowledge. So please share, and I think we should be that group that, you know, who is always advanced in terms of with the latest updates and making sure that whatever is said is also validated at our end, because we all have this. We can actually make it more evidence-based. So I think the next step I would definitely like to see is about the rice, and you know, is there any substance to it, and what happens exactly? So maybe that is something I would be really interested in knowing. So keep in touch, and we'll definitely keep you updated with whatever. And I think we are also planning a camp at the USC office, because USC is funding this entire thing, and y'all are getting to do this course absolutely free of cost. So I think it's give back time where we go to USC and see how they have. We did this with the last batch also, and we can do this with your current batch where you can actually go, because y'all enjoyed the camp. Mm-hmm. So we'll try and have more opportunities where we get to do camps and at least spread awareness about you know, where people are, where are the gaps, and how we as nutritionists and educators can fill in the gap. So I think that will be our service to society. So wherever required, we may seek your help. And whoever is available can come. And this USV camp is definitely compulsory. And other camps, wherever, I mean, if they are working and if they have their commitments, internship, etc. But I think we all will benefit out of it, because the more you interact with people, the more cases you see. This is just what you've learned is obviously what we've spoken with our experience, but it's very important for you all also to gain your individual experiences with patients. And the more you see patients, the more experience you will get, and you will learn more through those experiences. So we'll definitely keep you involved in whatever we do in the future.
Half day camp at US Vitamin head office. It is at Govandi. and we will demonstrate to them our gratitude by service, right? We have done one camp, and on that day we had a distribution of certificate, right? So we will call their senior or owner or somebody, you know, at least we will request Dr. Farida, who is a medical director and a good friend of mine, to be there, you know. So we will do one good quality camp, and we will have a certificate distribution on the same day, and we will show them that we did one camp, you know, for right. We will show that video also, or whatever pictures we have from that. And more practice we do, right, more powerful will become. Now I already heard, you know, that you have already started putting it into practice, right? And that happiness is a different, you can't describe that, you know, right? So I want that happiness to come. And when you publish something, your name comes, and all the medical fraternity reads your name. You get my point? You come at a different pedestal, right? And when someone, you know Papa Nicolaus Stein? You heard of Papa Nicolaus Stein? Anybody has heard something called Papa Nicolaus Stein? Everybody says no, right? Now I'll tell you. Have you heard of pap smear? Have you heard of pap smear? So what is that pap? Papa Nicolaou. Now Papa Nicolaou is an Italian doctor. He was an intern, and at that time he used methylene blue to stain cancer cells, suspected cancer cells. And he described a technology as an intern, right? That this is the easiest and certain method of suspecting malignancy. He was an intern. And now Papa Nicolaus Stein has become a day-to-day procedure with all the gynecologists throughout the world. How that occurred? Because he has a courage to publish. He had a courage to publish as an intern. Right. Now it has become a right. So what I am trying to tell you, that this diet challenge is maximum with the doctors. The way in which we eat at the conference, it is a world conference. Crows are black in all the countries. So when we as a doctor do not respect dietary habit, what right we have in advising somebody? When we are not exercising, right, what right we have? And we are supposed to be, you know, the torch bearers. But it is a blind torch bearer. Hum tumko rasta dikhata hai, hum nahi chalega. So the exercise which I have given you, think it very differently. That today, you know, when you sit for your lunch, right, by default take picture first. Whatever you are going to eat, by default you take a picture first, right? And just do one exercise, that how much carb will be inside, how much calorie will be inside, how much protein will be inside, what type of bolus I will take, square or wide, what just think of yourself, you know. If I am on a pump, right, and you will automatically reach this and start weighing. You will automatically ask your mom, usme kya hai? Mom ko bhi lagega ki uska dimag bigad gaya hai. Achanak to wo puche kuch shaadi baadi ka plan hai kya aage? Haan, ye kya hai? But that's a change in you. That's a change in you, right? And that will lead us long back. Because we did one experiment, Cheryl, at clinic. we told them to just tell, you know, कि तुम्हारा डाइट रिकॉल बोलो, मॉर्निंग्स इवनिंग क्या खाता है वो बोलो, सैटरडे संडे को क्या खाता है बोलो, और कितना घर में आदमी है और कितना ऑयल जाता है. टू आवर सरप्राइज, और स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन, स्प्राउट खाता है, सलाड खाता है, सब्जी खाता है, एंड दैट ऑन वन साइड. एंड जस्ट वी मेक सम सिंपल चेंजेस इन अ डाइट ऑन द सेम शिट एंड वी स्टार्टेड सीइंग द रिजल्ट. सो आई वॉन्ट टू कैरी फॉरवर्ड दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट नाउ विद द पिक्चर्स. पहले पेशेंट ये खाता था, अभी ये खाता था, दैट्स इट. नाउ व्हेन यू पब्लिश दिस राइट, नोबडी विल चैलेंज दैट. एंड व्हेन यू पुट द वेइंग वेट राइट, नोबडी विल चैलेंज दैट, बिकॉज नोबडी इज डन सच स्टडी सो फार इन रियल लाइफ. एंड व्हेन एवरीबडी डज टूगेदर राइट, दैट डेटा हैज टू बी रोबस्ट. सो I put a different word of request. Take it seriously and let's start doing it. Usav, you have that email with you. Mass post it today only, right? And let us say within a week, where do we stand, right? Okay? Chal, bye.